The next step is to add a laser projector to our project. In order to do that, I will go to the Library tab, select Fixtures, and then Laser. There are several different types of lasers from different manufacturers we could add. However, I will select Generic and choose Full-Colored RGB Laser Projector. Then click on Add to Scene. From this dialog, I could change parameters such as the number of projectors to add and the offset of where it will get added into the scene. However, I will just click OK. Now I am ready to position my laser projector. First thing I will do is zoom out slightly. By default, Realizzer will add new items from the library in the center of the Project 3D space. I can from here scale an object, rotate it, or move it by selecting one of the icons in the toolbar for the corresponding action. In this case, I want to move. There are arrows that will allow me to move the item along the X, Y, and Z axis by clicking on the arrow with the left mouse button. And moving the mouse either up or down will increase or decrease the value. I can also change the value in the object's settings, which gives us a much more precise fine-tuning of an object's position. However, using the arrows in the 3D space is much quicker. By switching to rotate, I can set where the projector is pointing. The red line tells me which way the beam will shoot from the aperture. I want to select the yellow line, which will let me rotate along the x-axis, and set the projector pointing towards the back of the theater. Now I can fine-tune the rotations in the setting tab for the object. With my settings done, I will move this projector into position. I will shift this to the left, switch my view to the left, move my camera so I can see enough to move the projector along my z-axis, then approximate where this will line up with the crossbar I have set on the truss for this laser projector. Then I will switch back to my front view and align this projector with the bottom of the crossbar. Then I will switch to the top view and make sure the projector is in a position along the x-axis so that if I rotate the projector, it will not be obstructed by the truss. With the projector I just added, I will open the Settings tab. From the Settings tab, I can select which virtual laser channel this projector will listen to receive its commands from Pangolin Beyond. If I click on Activate, this will turn the projector on and off. The drop box lets me select which channel this is listening. This needs to match the value set in Beyond's Zone Advanced settings. First, I need to make sure I have enough laser channels listening in Realizzer. Go to the Files Application Settings dialog, then select Laser. Pay special attention to the message here. This indicates that the more laser channels we have listening, the more network bandwidth that will be consumed. This will adversely affect performance of Realizzer and rendering lasers. For this reason, I always turn my computer into airplane mode and make sure I do not have any Ethernet cables connected to the adapter. This will allow me to force all communication between Beyond and Realizzer to use a loopback adapter, which is infinitely faster and performs much better than any network device. For my project, I have 9 laser channels open, 1 for graphics and 8 for atmospheric zones. In Beyond, I need to go to the Setting Projector Zones. From here, I need to select the zone I want to set. Laser channels in the visualizer are done on a zone basis. This is so that you can have multiple projectors projecting the same zone. Multiple zones can output to the same channel. From here, I will select the Advanced tab for my main graphic zone and set the value to 1. This will need to match in Realizzer for my graphics projector. My atmospheric zone will be set to 2. My scanner 2 will be set to 3, and so on until I have each zone set to the channel that I want to project. Now that we have the projector set up, we need to duplicate it. For this particular setup, I want to mirror the right side from the left. Rather than having to re-import from the library, I will duplicate the existing projector and move it into place on the stage left crossbar. Select the projector in the Objects tab and choose Duplicate with the right mouse click. I only need to do one, so I will hit OK. Next, I need to zoom out and see the entire stage. The duplicate projector is selected by default, so all I need to do is move it across the stage to its crossbar. I will now zoom in close so I can adjust the projector. It is possible to adjust the projector by using the pan and tilt options, which will move it inside of its yoke.